Good morning, dear students. Welcome to the GK class. Dear students, as we know that nature is very important to us. Now the question arises, why nature is important to us? So the answer is very simple, that nature provides us a lot of things which are very useful to us in our daily life. We can't survive without our nature, without our environment, without plants and trees. We are directly connected with the nature. We are directly connected with our environment. We can't imagine our life without nature and without environment. So, this is very clear that nature, environment, and all the trees and plants are very important to us. Plants provide a lot of things. We get fruits, we get woods, we get fresh air, and a lot of things we get from our nature and our environment. But besides all these things, some plants have some medicinal use. We use that plants and their products for our medicinal purpose. And that are like the miracles of nature. That plants are just like miracles of nature, because why we say that they are the miracles of nature, why they are known as miracles of nature? Question arises that why we treat them as miracles of nature. So the answer is quite simple, because they provide us some extraordinary things. They provide us some extraordinary raw material which are being used by us for the medicinal purpose. Not for only medicinal purpose, but different type of product we get from the plants and trees, and various types of plants and trees which exist in our nature that are very useful to us. So, dear students, today we are going to discuss all about the nature, all about our environment, and all about those plants that are known as miracles of nature. Okay? We are going to discuss in detail their usefulness of that plant which are known as miracles of nature. Okay? So in that list, the very first thing aloe vera. I hope that you have heard about this aloe vera plant. You have already heard about this, but do you know the uses of this plant? This plant has many uses. Okay, now the question arises, why, how we can say that aloe vera comes under the category of miracles of nature? The first question that arises in our mind is that how can we say that aloe vera comes under the miracles of nature? How we can say that? We can say that because of its usefulness, it provides us a lot of things which are just like miracles to human beings. Okay, so we treat aloe vera as miracles of nature. Now, dear students, we are going to discuss what are the usefulness of aloe vera. Okay. Aloe vera is believed to help people stay young. Dear students, as we know that aloe vera has positive effect on our skin. People usually use aloe vera for two to make their skin glow. Okay, it increases the aloe vera is believed to help people stay young. And why this is believed? That because aloe vera makes our skin glow. Okay, so we can say that it has a positive. It has a positive effect on the skin. Effect on the skin. Okay. The juice of this plant is used for making cosmetics. For making cosmetics and wait, let me erase this and I will write this on. The juice of this plant is the juice of this plant is used for making
used for making cosmetics and medicines. Cosmetics and medicines. And medicines. And medicines for treating burns. For treating. For treating burns.
So dear students, if you are feeling some type of burning sensation on your skin, sometimes if we accidentally got any burning sensation or our skin get burned, then the medicines made up of aloe vera can be used there. Okay, the medicines which are made up of aloe vera can be used there to cure the burning sensation or burning effect of. So we can say that the juice of this plant is used for making cosmetics and medicines. The juice of this plant is used for making cosmetics and medicines for treating burns. Okay. Apart from our skin, as we know that it increases the glowness of our skin. Okay, this is very clear. Then apart from that, it can also be used for the burning sensation or burns. Okay, if you get any burn on your skin, then it can be used there. Okay, now the third very important fact is that
aloe vera contains over 20 minerals which are essential for
So this is very important fact. Imagine that this contains 20 more minerals which are essential for the human body. Okay, so just focus on the minerals. 20 minerals. Just focus on the fact that aloe vera has 20 minerals, not only 20 minerals, but more than 20 minerals, which are important to our body. So, how important is aloe vera? How important aloe vera is for us? Okay, you can imagine how important aloe vera is for us. Okay, so that's why. That's why we treat aloe vera as a miracle of nature. Nature has gifted us aloe vera as a miracle. Okay? So, now moving on to the next.
Indian ginseng. Indian ginseng. Ashwagandha. Okay. So the next miracle of nature is the herb which is known as Indian ginseng. In Hindi we can say that Ashwagandha. Okay. There are many uses of Ashwagandha. Dear students, do you hear the name Ashwa?
Ashwa?
Ashwa is a Hindi word, you know, Ashwa. Ashwa Turang, Ghoda. We can say that Ashwa is a Hindi word and that is horse, Ghoda. Okay?
So, it provides us such a strength just like a horse.
It strengthens our internal system. It boosted us. It provides more strength to our internal organs, just like what are that internal organs? That has our intestinal infections. Okay. It can be very useful in our intestinal infection, in nervous disorders, in all type of leprosy. Okay. So Ashwagandha has many uses. The Indian ginseng, also known as Ashwagandha, has many uses. I am going to write that one.
Indian ginseng is a herb. Ginseng is a herb. Is a herb used for treating. Used for treating nervous disorder. Nervous disorder. Nervous disorder. Orders. Intestinal infection. Intestinal infections. Intestinal infections and leprosy. And leprosy.
Okay. So dear students, you can see that, you can see here that Indian ginseng, which is also known as Ashwagandha in Hindi. Okay. Indian ginseng and Ashwagandha is the same thing. Okay. So Indian ginseng is a herb used for treating nervous disorders. If you have any type of nervous disorders, then Indian ginseng or Ashwagandha can be very useful in that. And also, apart from the treatment, apart from the nervous disorders, it can also be very useful in intestinal infections, all type of intestinal infection. And we know that how important function play our in, how important is the function of our intestine in our body. Our intestines should be in a very healthy state, in a very healthy condition, because all type of absorption takes place in our intestine. Okay, as you know that when we eat food, then food, the complex food materials breaks down into simpler substances in our stomachs. Okay, we know that this is very quite simple, that when we eat, then complex food materials breaks down into simpler substances in our stomachs, and then that food goes through our intestine. Okay, so our intestine should be very healthy, and if we have any type of intestinal infection, then Indian ginseng or ashwagandha can be very useful in that condition. Dear students, we further discuss the apart from these uses, there are many other uses of ashwagandha. We will discuss in our next class in detail. Okay, thank you.